When you meet someone who is not at the same level of consciousness as you are, and you start complaining about them or you start judging them, it just shows that you need to start holding space for other people. A lot of us expect us from other people. And when you expect you from other people, you completely forget that they have their own journey, that their state of consciousness reflects what they are going through right now, and not everyone will have the same state of consciousness. So instead of complaining about them, you have to learn to hold space for such people, because complaining is a very bad vibration. When you complain about something, you put out the energy which is problem oriented, not solution oriented. You are programming yourself to focus more and more on the problems instead of the solutions. But on the other hand, when you hold space for people, you are being patient with them. You can make them question about the things that you want them to understand. Because true knowledge can't be forced, it can only be learned. When you force your own level of consciousness on someone, they can't really understand it, because they will just understand on the superficial level. But true wisdom comes from within, it can't be forced on you. So if you really want to bring a change in someone, you have to make them question what they are doing. You have to make them question their way of being, instead of forcing, imposing your wisdom on them. And if you look at your own journey, a lot of wisdom that we have right now, we gained it on our own. A lot of people tried to give us wisdom, knowledge, but in many cases we only understand things when we go through them. So for example, if someone deals with the problems in a very unhealthy way, or if their lifestyle is not good for them, and if you can see that, you are aware of that, and you exactly know that why are they suffering, instead of glorifying your wisdom, try to understand them, hold space for them, ask them that why are they this way. One of the spiritual traps when you awaken is that you start labeling everything as awake and asleep. You just put everything inside a box. You put the entire person inside a box. And if you put yourself in the other person's shoes, you may remember your older self, the self which was still holding all these programs of fear, shame and guilt. So we have no right actually to judge any person at all, because everyone is going through their own journey. The more you judge, the more you reveal that what you need to work on yourself. So instead of telling them that what they should do, you should make them question that why are they acting this way? What are the programs that are holding them back? And you can also be the example of a person who deals with problems in a healthy way, who has a healthy lifestyle or whatever. So instead of condemning others, instead of judging others, accept them. And this is what is happening with the cancel culture. People are becoming polarized. We just hold on to one perception and we are not open for understanding the other perspective. And this is not healthy for the collective consciousness. Because when you are just fixated on one perception, you have lost touch with your multidimensional nature. You become a linear thinker and everything becomes fixed. So you have to understand the other person's perspective to see the whole picture. So this is a very small thing that can bring a huge difference in your own energy. You will get rid of the energy of complaining and judging others, and you will replace that by acceptance. The more you accept someone, the more you hold space for others, the more you are getting connected to your heart center. Because the other person is just a mirror for your own consciousness. We all are one. So in a way, when you judge the other person, when you complain about the other person, you are just complaining about another aspect of yourself, another version of yourself. It's like you are complaining about yourself, because we all are one. So don't be the person who participates in the cancel culture, who just holds on to the one perspective and become biased, because we are multidimensional beings. We are not here to just experience life from one perspective. And the entire purpose of this universe is to experience as much as reality is possible. The universe is experiencing itself. The consciousness in you and me is experiencing itself through everyone around you, through every being, human, animals, the planet itself, in infinite ways. Life is not linear. There are multiple possibilities. So don't become close-minded. Don't fall under this trap of judging others on the basis of awake and asleep. Try to see your older self in the people who are not awake yet. Because we all were ignorant in some point of our life. Not everyone is born awake. We all have our journey. So hold space for others and connect with your heart center, because that's the portal to unity consciousness. We have to stop playing the game of duality if we truly want to merge with the unity consciousness. Much love to you all.